on the X Factor.
Why?
Listen to your heart.
You don't sing like a human being.
You've raised the bar on band.
We're just smashing dreams in there.
Somewhere amongst all this rubbish, there's a star.
Show me heaven.
Ah! World's greatest.
I like you very much.
Oh, my God!
Absolutely loved your voice.
You look like an attractive Jerry Halliwell. This way.
We've had an accident at the house.
We need to get her flight. Now.
We were told to be three judges here, and it is not fair.
That's what this business is all about. Ambition, ambition, ambition.
To Louis Walsh's hometown, it's no surprise that he's feeling optimistic about the day ahead.
I think today could be the day that we find this person, this megastar.
Today is National Talent Day.
The auditionees have turned out in their thousands, all hoping to be the next lucky act to make it to the top, just like last year's winner, Shane Ward. And no one wants to be more like Shane than 21-year-old factory worker, Cahol.
I love Shane Ward, that's it. Just love him to bits. The way he looks, the way he sings, it's all real. Just love to be like him. When I look in that room, I want the judges to see that I'm the next Shane Ward.
Come on, hurry up, we've got all day. Who would you compare yourself to in the charts today?
I'd like to be like Shane Ward.
Okay.
And know where I come from, you know my story. I'm here to make you plead, make you right. Well, I know that acting foolish, but I promise you no more. I finally found it, something worth reaching for. I'm not here to say I'm sorry, I'm not here to lie to you. I'm here to say I'm ready.
I've got to stop this.
Sorry.
I've got to stop that. Who did you sing this song to before you got here today?
My whole family.
And what did they say?
I was good a wee bit.
They said it was good?
Yeah.
Whatever. Louis, yes or no?
Carl, it has to be no.
Sharon?
It's a no from me.
I mean, Cahol, it was absolutely dreadful. I'm not being rude. It was absolutely terrible.
Thanks.
All right.
Thank you.
So it looks like Cahol won't be the next Shane Ward, and unfortunately, he's not the only one unable to achieve his goal.
What's the name of the duo?
Mission.
Okay, and why are you here?
We're on a mission for Jesus. We want to serve God in singing, and we want to spread that to the world.
God, yeah. Okay.
This is the air I breathe, your holy presence in me.
So you want to spread the word? Well, it's not going to be spread very far, girls, after that.
It's been 7 hours and 15 days.
It was terrible. Flat as a pancake.
Let's take a cruise. When I get off the plane, my childhood dream led me here. From Mayhaw.
I can't understand anything you say.
Give me a chance.
I really do adore you, but I have to say no.
Sorry,
so
Mickey.
Cute.
Someone else whose goal is to be number one is 24-year-old waitress Cutluano.
I believe in myself. I believe I'm beautiful. I believe I've got a beautiful body. I'm confident that I can sing any song. I believe I can go as far as top. I can reach the top, yeah, if given a chance. I can go as far as anything. I mean, the sky is the limit.
Why are you here?
Because I believe in myself and I believe I've got the X factor.
Okay.
Listen to your heart when he's talking to you. I don't know where you're going, and I don't know why. Listen to your heart before you tell him goodbye.
Your problem is, Cutluano, is that you don't sing like a human being.
No, your voice sounds like a little sheep.
Yeah,
you know,
you
those
don't
little
sound
things
like,
you turn over and it bleeps.
You don't sound like a human, and that is the fundamental problem we have here.
You look great, but you sound awful.
Okay.
I'm saying no.
I'm saying no.
I absolutely have to say no on this.
Thank you. She did sound like a sheep, though.
Weird.
I got a cat.
After a disappointing morning, the judges take a break.
Gotta be honest with you. I think this almost was a waste of time.
I'm not disagreeing with you. Talent is out there. They should have come in and sang.
Despite a disastrous start, it's going to take more than a few no's to get the Dubliners down. So can 23-year-old shop assistant Morgan finally be what the judges are looking for?
My big dream would just be to, I guess, be a successful entertainer and be a credible songwriter and just end up singing. Like, that's what I want to do. I just want to entertain. And that's kind of it. You can't explain why you want to do it. It's just, if it's in you, you just want to do it, and that's it.
Hello.
Hi.
Your name is?
My name's Morgan Dean.
Are you good enough to win?
Hopefully I am. Hopefully you think I am.
Off you go, Morgan.
Oh, I want to dance with somebody. I want to feel the heat with somebody. Yeah, I want to dance with somebody. Oh, with somebody who loves me.
You're very cute, Morgan.
And you look absolutely great, Morgan.
You do. You look divine.
You look great.
Louis, yes or no?
Yes.
I'm going to say yes. Yes, ma'am.
Okay,
bye-bye.
And with Morgan through, the floodgates finally open and the yeses just keep on coming.
I'm a genie in a bottle. You got to rub me the right way.
I'm going to say yes.
I'm going to say yes.
You're through to the next round.
Oh, my God. Thank you. You're in the arms of the angel.
You're through to the next round. Well done.
Shines down the valley, the wind blows up the alley.
Louis, yes or no?
Yes.
Oh my God!
After a successful session, the judges break for lunch. But backstage, Sharon has just received some bad news.
I have to go home.
Why?
Simon, can I leave now?
Why?
We've had an accident at the house. There was a fire at the house.
Everyone's right. Are you ready?
I'm all right.
Hmm?
I'm all right.
Well, then we need to get her a flight. Now. Here you go.
Sharon.
Still to come.
We were told to be three judges here, and it is not fair.
This way.
Sorry.
Welcome back to the X Factor, where the auditions continue in Dublin. Earlier, Sharon received news that a fire had swept through the Osborne mansion.
We've had an accident at the house.
We need to get the flight. Now.
With so many people to see, the auditions continue with just Simon and Louis on the judging panels. Someone who's confident that they can impress the boys is 18-year-old Latvian national singing champ, Elena.
I won a national singing contest back at home. I got a grand prize. Singer is the person who can touch people's hearts, who can hold them, and when I sing, people can cry or bring the joy and happiness to them. We just have to believe in ourselves that we can do this, go change the world.
How are you?
Come in.
My name is Elena. I'm originally from Latvia, but I live in Ireland. I love this country, and music is my passion, of course. And
are you any good?
I think I'm good. I got a grand prize in national singing contest back in Latvia when I was 16. I wrote more than 100 songs, so I'm here. I'm ready.
Okay.
Okay.
Who better know your friends, or else you will get burned. Who it feels so good when you let go of all the drama in your life. Yeah, yeah, yeah. No more pain, no more pain, no more game. Messing with my mind, no more drama in my life. No, 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 I don't ever want to hurt again.
Thank you, sorry. Simon?
That was catchy, wasn't it?
I'm sorry.
A little bit over the top, darling, I thought. The only line I remember was no more pain.
I'm sorry.
Louis, yes or no?
I'm going to have to say no.
Absolutely no, sweetheart.
Elena seems to have set Louis and Simon off. And now they've got the giggles, there's nothing and no one that can stop them.
Just the two of us. We can make it if we try.
This way.
I'm tired of crying, and all you lying, that's why I'm buying our lips are true, my china doll is just like
John,
you.
I'm going to stop. It's not you. I'm really sorry. There is a little bit of a charisma problem, John. That's my main concern. I don't think you would excite an audience.
Just the two of us.
Look at... sorry. Look at the stars. Look how they shine for you.
And though I know I'll never let her out of my heart, she never loved
Aiden,
me back.
Aiden, I can't hear any more of that, I'm afraid. You have a terrible voice.
It didn't sound right.
No, it didn't sound right at all. Louis, yes or no?
No.
It's a no.
We can make it if we try.
Sometimes, you know what it is, you just start laughing, you get the giggles, and
you can't stop. Yeah, even you're not really laughing at them.
And it wasn't even funny.
You're laughing because you shouldn't be laughing. It's like, you know when you're in church and you start laughing at nothing.
It's embarrassing.
Yeah.
You should apologise.
I don't think so.
No, you should.
News of Sharon's absence filters through to the contestants. Knowing they now need two yeses from Simon and Louis, the pressure's rising in the holding room. And desperate for a unanimous yes is 19-year-old Rudy.
My big dream in life is to be a superstar, to be on stage singing, for that to be my job. Like, most people have a job in an office, and I wouldn't enjoy that. I'd love to be on a stage singing, playing the piano, just entertaining people. I would love, yeah.
Hi, come in. Come and stand on the X, please.
Stand on the X.
Yeah. Yes. And what's your name?
Rudy.
Rudy?
Yeah.
Okay, and what are you going to sing?
In the Air Tonight by Phil Collins.
Oh, yeah, I know, Joe.
Want to sing it?
Yeah.
I can feel it coming in the air tonight. Oh, Lord. And I've been waiting for this moment for all of my life. Oh Lord, oh Lord.
Okay, Rudy. I don't get it.
I thought he was okay.
Yeah, that's what I mean, okay. Mm. But nothing, nothing I haven't seen or heard a million times.
I think he's okay, son.
Oh, give me a break.
I think he's okay.
Please give me a chance.
I don't think he's bad.
What do you want to hear? What do you want to see? What do you want to hear?
This is not a request service.
What if I sang something fast or something?
Rudy, you prepared for the audition and then you delivered nothing. Nothing.
Nothing.
Nothing.
I've seen you be wrong with people in the past.
Not many times, Rudy. Yes or no?
Oh, I'm saying yes. Because I think he's got the potential to be better.
Yeah.
Rudy, I'm going to say no.
Please.
No. It's pointless.
If Sharon, it's not fair because Sharon's not here as well.
We'll call her.
It's not fair because...
Sharon, Rudy, I'm telling you now.
It's not fair. I swear it is not fair.
Rudy.
We were told to be three judges here and it is not fair.
Sharon would say
we'll send a letter of complaint, Rudy.
Sharon would say
she wouldn't have said yes. No, you're being ridiculous now. It's a no.
What do I know? Okay.
You wasn't that bad.
I don't even know why you encouraged him, really.
Why? Because I thought he was okay.
Okay.
I thought he was okay.
Yeah, right.
Nope. They're wrong.
I don't know what Sharon would have said.
She would have said no.
Sharon, you should have been here. It's not fair. It's not fair on everyone.
And as the auditions continue, it's not only Rudy that's missing Sharon.
What's that all about, Sharon? Where were you? We needed your help and you deserted us.
I was ripping that Sharon wasn't there.
If she was here, maybe things would be different, but she wasn't.
It should be three judges, man.
So many people needed your yes.
Sharon, come back because 2 out of 3 ain't good enough.
You should have just given me a chance.
The auditionees are missing Sharon and are desperate for a yes. Can 16-year-old trainee hairdresser Wayne turn it all around? To ensure he doesn't get intimidated by Simon and Louis, he's brought along his mum and dad and entire family for support and hopes to give them a better life if he wins.
It'd change my life forever, wouldn't it? I wouldn't go buying all cars and all and big houses, and I would like to stay...
Feet on the ground.
Can't even explain how much I want this off.
We have told him it's the hardest thing. He's chose to do with his life, but we'll back him all the way, 100%.
He's a star in the making.
This kid can sing.
My heart is racing here.
No words to show you feel that your love for me is real.
How you doing?
How you caving?
And what makes you different from everybody else?
I think I'm a good singer. They say I'm a good singer.
Okay. Off you go.
I'm that star up in the sky. I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it. I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of hope when my back's against
the ropes. Okay, Wayne, thank you very much. Simon?
You've got quite a nice voice, Wayne.
Thanks.
Yeah, you can definitely sing. Whether or not you have that X factor, I'm not sure. You're very nervous, aren't you?
I am nervous.
He's only 16.
All my family knows outside.
Are your family here?
I'm nervous in case. I don't want to let them down.
What would it mean to you to get through, Wayne?
I love music. Music is my passion, and I wanted to sing ever since I was small. Please put me through.
Louis, yes or no? You need 2 yeses.
I am a mountain. I'm going to say yes, Simon. Simon, I think he's worth it. I really do. I know it means everything to you. Go on. If anybody asks you who I am.
I'm gonna say yes. You're
yes! Oh my God!
Catch you go.
And as the day draws to a close, it isn't only Wayne that has reason to celebrate.
It's a huge opportunity for me, and I feel it's really just the start.
Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah.
Time to put things in perspective and remember what you wanted all along in your life.
It means so much to me, it means so much to my family and all. My family was out there cheering for me. I can't get over it, I still can't get over it now, I can't even talk to you.
Still to come.
You've raised the bar on Bang.
Why have you come back?
Welcome back to The X Factor. We've left Dublin behind to find out what's on offer here in Birmingham. Following the fire at her home, Sharon has rejoined her fellow judges. With the trio back together, the auditions are in full swing and they're off to a flying start.
I feel like this is the beginning.
What a pleasant surprise.
I'm going to say yes.
100% yes.
Yes, cheers from me.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
And I'll keep a part of you with me.
You look like an attractive Jerry Halliwell.
Thank you.
Yes.
Alexandra, you're through to the next round.
Oh, God. Speaking words of wisdom, let it be.
You're good fun and you've got good personality.
Yes.
Yes.
I'm going to say yes too.
It's all going well. And the next contestant is hoping to continue the success. 21-year-old student, AJ.
I've loved music all my life and I've always sung, you know. But I've never really got an opportunity like this, you know, where I could showcase, you know, my talent. My ultimate dream would be to win, you know, the X Factor. And even more than that, to go on to become a superstar. That is where I want to be, yes.
Hi. How are you?
Very fine, thank
you. Good. What's your name?
I'm AJ.
AJ. Okay. Off you go.
Okay. Some people live for the fortune. Some people live just for the fame. Some people live for the power, yeah. Some people live just to play the game. Some people think that life's so bold, so full of the superficial.
All right.
If a mouse could sing, it would sound like that.
In pain, in the trap, in the mouse trap.
I'd love to get an opportunity to really show you that I can sing, you know.
You can't. You cannot sing.
I can sing.
No, you've got no chance.
It's all over today.
You've raised the bar on Bang. You have.
You are 1,000,000% not going through to the next round.
No, Abraham.
After a promising start, AJ misses the mark. But the groups are hoping that they can get things back on track.
I'm all out of love, sweet dreams are made of thee. Don't you wish your girlfriend was raw like me?
Next in are a duo hoping that their unique style will set them apart from the competition.
We are Dramatics and we have the X Factor.
We take songs and we harmonise them very differently, and we think that's going to give us a real edge.
We think we'd appeal to everybody, from teenagers through to the more mature end. Being a singing teacher, I can make sure that the technicalities are correct, i.e. we have the right starting note, that the harmonies will be accurate and will work in an a cappella or an accompanied situation.
Hi, how are you?
Thank you. And you?
Very well.
OK, what are you going to sing?
We're going to sing What I Did For Love from the show A Chorus Line.
Wonderful.
Great song.
kiss today goodbye, the sweetness and the sorrow. Wish me luck the same to you, but I can't regret what I did for love.
Guys, thank you. Louis.
I don't know what to say. It was different.
We are different.
In
unique.
A very, very odd way. I think you're a very odd couple. Just odd looking,
Louis.
Sounding, everything.
I could imagine you outside my house at Christmas time singing Silent Night.
Dressed up.
Yeah.
And not getting any money.
No, a bit of money.
Dickensian.
But I think that's it.
When we put the group together, we knew we were very different, and you'd either like us or you wouldn't.
I didn't. All right, Louis, yes or no?
It's going to have to be no.
Sharon?
No.
All right, it's a no, guys, but nice to meet you both.
And you, thank you.
Take care. Unbelievable.
The dramatics fail to impress, and as the day goes on, things only get worse.
The X Factor has arrived!
I'm a creep, I'm a widow.
Probably the right line to end that one on, I think, Valerie. My God. Weird.
Bizarre. Very bizarre.
You just sit there and think, why did you bother entering a competition like this?
Bizarre. Quite bizarre.
Despite all the no's, everyone's still dreaming of a brighter tomorrow.
Everybody wants to be famous.
To be a well-known sex symbol.
I love fame.
I like to walk into Asda when I'm doing my shopping and see my CD there.
But no one wants their name in lights more than 16-year-old student Chloe.
Look at me.
Crave fame, something that everyone wants it because it's easy and there are no obstacles, no working, it's just wow, you're in the limelight and everyone wants a piece of you, it's amazing.
Ow! Middle of the bit!
Like if everyone in the world was to know who I was. Oh, she won the X Factor, oh look what she's done, it would be really fun.
Hello.
Oh, you in this evening?
You walk just like a model. You've got that pony top when you walk. So, Chloe, what's your dream?
My dream is to be a singer. My dream is to be on the X Factor. I want to be on that stage so badly.
Liken your style to somebody.
Let's go for the Motown stuff. A bit of Mariah Carey, a bit of Whitney Houston, a bit of Aretha Franklin, Alicia Keys.
Okay, great.
Singing my song, drumming my pain with his fingers, living my life with his words, killing me softly with his song, killing me softly.
Thank you, Chloe. Sharon?
Yeah, Chloe, you're 16. You have no idea who you are yet. You're just heavily influenced by all the divas out there.
It's like you've been bred in a laboratory as some music creation, you know? Second of Mariah, second of Christina, but none of it came out right.
Can I try again, please?
No, I couldn't hear it again, Chloe. Look, Chloe, you represent millions of 16-year-old people in this country today who just want to be famous like that, right? But it's all too much, too over the top. It didn't work. Louis, yes or no?
I have to say no.
Sharon?
No, you're not ready yet, Chloe.
Sorry, sweetheart, it's a no.
I'm not a girl.
Thanks.
Hey, me. I sent over the top.
I tell you what, she is every parent's nightmare.
I don't expect that to happen.
Doesn't want to work for a living. I want it all now.
Dearie me. Oh, it's fine. I'm fine.
I
Chloe's dream is over, and after a disappointing afternoon, the atmosphere in Birmingham is tense. But one man is desperate to turn things around. 38-year-old Ian.
Of course it's my dream. And of course, every singer gets setbacks. There's only a certain amount of no's you can stand now. I'm 38, I've got a little girl now, she's 4 years of age. She gave me a little teddy bear today. Kissed it 3 times and said, just do it, Dad. So there you go.
If today the judges say, give up the dream, you'll write off your lifelong ambition of singing for a living.
Yeah, for sure.
Thank you.
This is it for me now. Last chance to learn.
Hi, guys.
Hello.
Hiya.
Why are you here, Ian?
To make life better for myself and my family and live the dream. That's what I want to do. I want to do it. I've done the clubs up and down the country for years, and I stopped about 5 years ago performing properly. This is my last chance. It's last chance saloon.
Okay.
This is it. I've been really trying, baby, trying to hold back this feeling for so long. And if you feel like I feel, baby, then come on. Well, come on. Woo, let's get it on. Ha, baby. Let's get it on.
Thank you. Sharon.
Is that your child's teddy you've got in your pocket?
She kissed it 3 times before I came out. So take that with you, Daddy.
Okay, we better vote. Sharon.
Yes.
Ian. Good singer. Very nice person. I don't think you have it. And I'm going to say no.
Okay.
Ian, when you walked into the room, I thought, absolutely no chance.
Okay.
And then you started to sing, and I absolutely loved your voice. So my answer is 100% yes. You're true. Love lift us up where we belong.
That teddy bear worked. What a nice,
great voice.
Oh, boy, what you put yourself through, I tell you what.
Anyway, that's for Charlotte.
Still to come.
Show me.
I thought you were literally going to explode by the end of that song.
Simon, have a heart.
Why have you come back?
Welcome back to The X Factor. The judges have jetted into Glasgow, and the Scots are brimming with confidence.
I've got a bubbly personality, and I have got a voice, and I would like it to be heard.
I have the confidence, the ability, hopefully I've got the looks.
And there's one woman who's in no doubt about her star credentials, 31-year-old civil servant Karen.
I think I've got a great singing voice, a very wide vocal range, and I know I have the ability to win the X Factor.
Hello. And your name is?
Karen Orr.
And why are you here today?
Because I want to win the X Factor.
Okay. Are you any good?
I'm great.
Okay. Off you go.
I've learned the hard way to never let it get that far. Because of you, I find it hard to trust not only me, but everyone around me. Because of you.
Thank you. That was all a bit of a struggle, actually, Karen.
I don't think so.
So you weren't struggling?
I think that was fine.
So you're judging yourself? So are you going to put yourself through to the next round?
I personally would.
You would?
Mm-hmm.
Good. Louis?
Karen, I didn't like it. I thought it was all a bit desperate. A bit over the top.
I was uncomfortable watching you perform.
Okay, I agree with that. You were getting redder and redder and redder, Karen. It was like a kettle boiling over. I thought you were literally going to explode by the end of that song, and I didn't like the sound of your voice.
But that's probably because I've got a viral infection.
Even going beyond the viral infection, I'm going to guess you're not very good.
I know I can do it.
No, you don't have a great voice. It's not obviously one of your best assets. It has to be a no from me, Karen.
Louis?
100% no.
Could I try another song?
No. I think you should just call it a day.
No, no, no. Good luck.
A heart.
It's a bad start to the day, and this next contestant knows only too well what it feels like to be told no. 19-year-old Rudy. At the Dublin auditions, Sharon rushed home early following a fire at her house. In her absence, Rudy didn't get the two yeses that he needed.
Oh, I'm saying yes.
Rudy, I'm going to say no.
Oh, please.
No, it's pointless.
I was a bit disappointed because I just felt that if Sharon had been there, it could have been a better decision. So that's why I'm back again. A lot of people were like, Rudy, you're mad. But let's go. I flew over to see all three judges, and that's how much I want this. If I get a no, I'll at least have tried.
We saw you in Dublin this week.
Yeah.
Why have you come back?
See Sharon.
To see Sharon.
Hang on.
Nice to meet you.
Good to meet you too.
Yeah, but yeah, I didn't know at the time why Sharon had left, so. And if I had have known, I wouldn't have been as argumentative about it.
I remember. Okay.
So
okay.
You've come all the way from Ireland?
Dublin.
Yeah.
Okay.
People get ready, there's a train coming. You don't need no baggage, you just get on board. All you need is faith to hear these olds humming. You don't need no ticket, you just thank the Lord.
Rudy, this must mean an awful lot to you to have travelled all this way.
It's what I do, it's what I want to do. This is like if for me.
Louis?
Rudy, I think you've got a potential, and I like the fact that you're passionate and the fact that you came all the way from Dublin to do a second audition. That's what this business is all about.
Determination.
Ambition, ambition, ambition.
Oh, okay, fine. So all you have to do is get on the plane and everything comes your way.
No, 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 Simon, no. If at first you don't succeed, you try and try again. You've been trying for years.
Yeah, but I knew what I was doing.
Not all the time.
Most of the time.
No, not all the time. None of us knew, Simon. You only learn from experience, and that's why I said yes to Rudy, and that's why I'm going to say yes again today to Rudy.
The voice was average. Wouldn't have wasted my time coming over here. It's a no.
Well, Rudy, you've come all this way. I'm going to have to agree. With Louis.
If at first you don't succeed, try and try again.
Back in the holding room, Rudy tells his dad the good news.
After last week in Dublin, seeing him this week, I can't compose myself. I just can't put it into words. I know he's going to be a star.
Rudy's on his way to boot camp, where one of the three judges will become his mentor.
Let's hope Rudy is not in Simon's category.
Absolute waste of time.
Oh. You won't give him a chance?
Absolutely, I've made it absolutely clear.
Send him home on the first day?
Bother me.
I'm not even arguing with you. Your ego is out of control today.
It's not out of control, Louis. It is.
The judges didn't agree on Rudy, but as the day goes on, they're unanimous about the talent in Glasgow.
It's hard for me to see, I'm sorry.
Yes.
And it's a yes.
So you're through?
Absolute legend.
Hey! Over the rainbow.
Oh, absolutely, yes.
Yes.
You're through to the next round.
also hoping for a yes from the judges of Brian and Craig, a.k.a. the McDonald brothers.
For your name to be known round about, I would just love to have a good bit of fame as well and just take it to the next level.
OK.
There she looks in my eyes and makes me realise when she says, don't worry, baby, don't worry, baby, everything will turn out all right.
You actually made that Beach Boys song not sound Californian, it sounded Scottish. You did, you made it your own.
Which was good.
Louis, yes or no?
Yes.
It is a yes. We're through to the next round.
Thank you very much.
Yes!
The day's drawing to a close, and the final contestant to see the judges is 31-year-old full-time mum, Kerry. Having overcome a lot in her life, she's determined to fulfil her singing dream.
When I was 13, fell and broke my back. And life changed completely for me at that point because from an early age, I'd been very involved in singing in ballet and in drama. I was surrounded by a very positive mum and friends that helped my morale, you know, and kept me going. But without the music, I wouldn't have had probably the drive and passion to be here today. I just want to prove to people that there's always a way forward. It's a state of mind sometimes, you know.
Hi, Kerry.
Hey.
All right, Kerry, you're 31 and you're from Glasgow. Kerry, can I ask you a personal question?
Yeah.
How come you're in the wheelchair?
When I was 13, I fell from a tree and broke my back.
And it's not held you back at all?
Not at all.
Well, she's always tried to fight in her corner, like, why? Because I've had an accident, should I be stigmatised and things like that? And it's, she fights really hard, harder than anybody else.
What are you going to sing for us?
Show Me Heaven by Maria McKee.
Good song.
Yeah, great song.
Hold my hand, don't let me fall. You've such amazing grace. I never felt this way. Oh, oh, show me heaven, cover me. Leave me breathless. Oh, show me heaven and me.
Thank you, Kerry. Lulu.
You definitely got a very good voice, Kerry, and you sang it like you meant it, and I really liked it. I was quite surprised.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah, you've got a great voice. You've got a great face, too.
Thank you.
I liked it very much. Simon?
You've got a good voice.
Thank you very much.
Good choice of song.
Thank you. A bit nervous.
So, Simon?
Yes.
Louis?
Yes.
And it's a yes from me.
Oh, my God.
You're through, kid.
Thank you.
Okay, good luck.
Thank you.
Let me open the door for some. She did it. See you later.
It just makes everything that I've ever been a part of and keep doing, it just makes it all the more worthwhile.
It's magnificent, magical. I'm so honoured to be a mum with this. I can only be happy for her. She's worked so hard.
I thought her voice was terrific and a beautiful song.
Mm.
Loved her. Absolutely loved her.
Oh, yep, it just keeps the belief in everything, the determination and the passion for it. You know, if you really want it enough, get in there and do it, definitely. It can only get better from here.
Next week, the auditions draw to a close.
This is a singing contest.
No, it isn't, actually.
Summertime. X Factor.
Let's talk about your vocals. Rubbish.
You can't sing. You have no talent. Get out. He does not deserve to sit in that chair.
And at last, Simon, Sharon and Louis find out which category they're mentoring for the rest of the competition.
We have reached a decision.
Tell me.
No.
That's The X Factor, next Saturday at 7:20.
God help them.
can now get all the latest music video clips from The X Factor, plus Real Tones gossip and more. Text to mobile 26330. It'll cost you 2 messages at your standard network rate. And don't forget Extra Factors on ITV2 later at 9:15. And here now with new stunts, surprises and shocks for the studio audience, Ant and Dec are back for a new series. Ant and Dec's Saturday Night Takeaway, next on ITV1.